anybody that hasn't seen my previous videos, I'm building an alternative to the traditional bee smoker. It is just a one button press smoker. I want to show beekeepers how they can mix the formulations that I'm making, how they can mix it themselves. When I say this to my friends that are smart in the business world, they tell me the following.
Michael, you have to keep this secret. You have to make sure that nobody ever knows about it. It's your secret sauce. It's the thing that makes you differentiated from everybody else, and make sure that you patent it. Once you've patented it, you can sell these in disposable containers so that they have to come to you and they can't refill it themselves. That way you make millions.
Well, I think that their advice is well-intentioned. I do know beekeepers, and beekeepers want to be able to DIY everything. They want to understand what they're putting on their bees. They want to understand what they're putting in their honey. It's not going to work. So I've decided to share my formulas with the beekeeping world, trying to make sure that it's open for people to be able to mix themselves using their own device, and everything is refillable. That way, if I get hit by a bus, you can mix these yourselves. So making this formulation isn't as easy as you would think it would be. A lot of people have said, well, just go out and buy some liquid smoke. It's a natural liquid. It should all be fine. But I've actually found with these liquid smokes that you get off the internet, they actually don't work very well, if at all. I started out by getting these liquid smokes. They're actually like a hickory flavor. They're just food additives that you put onto steaks in order to flavor different types of foods that you have. Even though I've given these to many, many people and said, smell these, what do you think? They say, oh, it's a very smoky smell. I found out that the bees don't find these to be very smoky at all. You'll occasionally get a little bit of a reaction with these types of liquids, but not very much at all. It really had me perplexed, and so I started to research different types of smells that repel bees. I looked into patents and scientific literature, and it was very interesting. I found a patent on using hardwood tars like this one here. This is birch tar, but the patent was from the 1950s. And I've actually talked to people who have used the product that this patent was for. It was called Hive Bomb, and it seemed to have worked really well with the bees. It was in an aerosol can that you would spray on the bees, and it worked really, really nicely from the people that I've talked to. And when you think about it, it makes a lot of sense, because wood tar would make sense when you're burning different types of things like wood in the smoker. You would end up with a lot of hardwood tar that would actually be sprayed on the bees, and that would be something that they would react to. Now, this is 100% conjecture, but I did read a post. There's not a whole lot about this on the internet, but they said that they believed that the Hive Bomb was taken off of the market because of fears in California of tar being aerosolized and it potentially being a carcinogen. This fear makes sense, because a lot of the things that are in cigarettes, like tar, are considered carcinogens. So another dead end. You can't just go and grab a bunch of tar, put it into a smoker, and aerosolize it. That's a really, really bad idea. But this got me thinking, could I make it to be tar-like? So smells that have a tar-like smell. There are a lot of different food additives that call themselves tar-like, but aren't actually tar. So why focus on smoke smells? The reason is that smoke smells create engorgement. Engorgement is when a bee fears that their hive is about to be destroyed for some reason. So they gorge on honey, nectar, all the different resources, with the idea that they're going to have to abscond soon. They don't actually abscond at that moment. They wait to see if the danger is real, and if so, then they would leave with those resources in order to build another home. The interesting thing about these studies is smoking is not the only thing that makes bees engorge. The other thing that makes bees engorge is high frequency movement of the hive. So think about if a bear comes and starts to shake the hive. This will also make engorging happen. What was really interesting in the scientific study was that that type of engorging actually made the bees more angry. When they got smoked, they were more likely to engorge and more likely to be calm. When they were actually engorging because of a disturbance, because of a vibration, they were actually more aggressive. The study was really interesting. They used balls to be able to see how many stings, counting actually the number of stings, using smoke, not using smoke, shaking the hive. So all of this is to say that we want to use the same smoky smells to get the bees to react the same way that they would with a smoker. And I have found that testing with things like visual aspects of smoke, things like heat of the smoke, these things don't actually make the bees engorge like the smell of the smoke. They're a very olfactory creature, and so the smell of smoke is definitely what we want to create. So some of you might be wondering, how do I smoke the bees and make sure that I'm not actually hurting them when I'm trying out a new smell? The first thing that I do when I'm trying out a new formulation, I will look on the internet and see if there's any data on the use of these different components that I'm trying out, in order to make sure that somebody hasn't found that there's some detrimental effect that they have on honeybees. Then, after doing that, I will try it on yellow jackets in my yellow jacket trap in my apiary. Think of it like trying out cosmetics on a monkey before trying it out on your grandma.
I'm not really worried about what happens to these yellow jackets. That may be cruel to say, anybody that loves yellow jackets out there, but they really are horrible to my honeybees. So I don't mind sacrificing a few of them before sacrificing any kind of bees.
After seeing that the yellow jackets are fine, I take some honeybees and I put them into a jar. I shoot some smoke into that jar, and then I have a second jar with the same number of honeybees in it, just as a control. And then I'm able to see whether there's an effect on the bees or not. After a couple hours, I release the honeybees back to their hive. They're all fine. So coming back to the liquid smokes, why is it that these don't work the way that you would expect them to? Again, I've brought them to a lot of different friends, had them smell it. Every single one of them says, oh my God, that's a very smoky smell. But the bees don't find it to be very smoky. What I found when I started to really ask people, what are you smelling, was that they're actually smelling barbecue smells. My hypothesis is that human beings think of barbecue as being fiery because we smoke meats. Bees are not carnivores. They're not even omnivores. Bees are actually herbivores. They eat pollen. They eat nectar. Friends at a picnic or at a barbecue will oftentimes say, oh, I have a honeybee in my Italian beef. And I'll say, guarantee, that's a yellow jacket. They're carnivores, not honeybees. So getting back to these liquids, they smell very smoky to human beings who associate barbecue with smoke. But I think that to the bee, objectively, there's no reason for them to think of it as smoky. It's just a meaty smell. So this brings me to focusing on wood smells that have a smoky smell to them. So a mix of wood smells and smoke smells that I think are going to be the right combination. Speaking of wood smells and smoke smells, a lot of beekeepers have said to me is pine needles is their secret weapon. And they've talked to me about using pine needle oils with smoky smells. It's an interesting idea. I haven't really tried it on the bees yet. I have made a few formulations to try out. My wife calls it the pine saw smell, and it kind of turned me off a little bit to it because it really does smell very pine saw-y. I'm not sure that I really want that smell in my apiary all the time. Maybe if I were to take the pine needle oil down a few notches in the formulation, maybe then it wouldn't have such a pine saw smell to it and the bees would still be able to detect it. Again, a lot of this is stuff that I'm still experimenting with very actively with beta testers. You may be wondering why I actually have a black version of this. The reason is because I've shipped out all of my prototypes to beta testers in Texas and Florida, and they're currently using them. I printed this out. It's actually a stronger PLA plus material in order to be able to be knocked around a little bit. It's a little bit coarser as far as the granularity on it. It's not as pretty as the other ones are. Definitely don't want to use black in the bee yard. People will lose it. It was just the material that I had at the time to print these out. And so I'll be printing out my other ones in yellow. I finally did find a PLA plus that's in yellow that I can use, which is really cool. Although I do think it looks pretty cool. This isn't going to be the color that I'm going to go with in the final product. I've also been trying out vetiver, which is an interesting essential oil. It has a very smoky smell to it, and the bees actually do react to this one pretty well. It has a very musky smell to it as well. Vetiver essential oil is made by steam distilling the roots of the vetiver plant. The vetiver plant is a bush grass. They take those roots and they steam distill the essential oils out of them, and that's how you get the vetiver essential oils. It has a very musky smell to it. To be honest, I don't love this smell very much. It's pretty strong, and so I'm still continuing to experiment with things that have more of that woody smell to it. I've been looking at a lot of different essential oils from India, from Asia. There's a lot of different ones that have a very smoky smell to them that's really interesting to key in on. I think that we're gonna be finding a lot of really interesting smells that the bees are gonna react. So I started out with these liquid soaps. I started out with these liquid soaps. I started building my formulations using liquid smoke. That word. Why do I keep saying liquid soaps?